Hello, welcome to the channel. Today I'm going to be looking at how to check and adjust the ignition timing on a Honda CT110. If that's something you're interested in, stick around and I'll get straight into it. So we'll look at how to check and adjust the timing on my 1985 6 volt postie. There are some subtle differences between the 6 volt and 12 volt models. Most of the changes are improvements. But in this case, this is one thing that I think is not as good. On the 6 volt postie, you can adjust the ignition timing really easily by rotating the pulse generator plate in the cylinder head. So it's still not that easy to see, but we'll have a good look. As the piston comes to the top of its stroke, we get to some timing marks. First of all, there is an F, and the actual fire mark is there. And then slightly further around, there's another mark with a T, which stands for TDC or top dead center. So with the mark next to the T in line with the pointer, the piston is at the top of the cylinder or top dead center. As the engine rotates and the F aligns with the pointer, we get ignition. So here we have our strobe, the timing light, and it has two clips that clip onto a battery, and this lead that clips around the spark plug lead. When we pull the trigger, the engine running, the timing light will flash every time the spark plug fires, and because of the strobe effect, that will actually freeze this motion, so it will give the effect that the timing mark is not moving, and then we can adjust the pulse generator plate to fine-tune the timing. We can also check if the advance and retard unit is working properly. But if you don't have one of these, is there another way? Yes, there is, and I'll show you that as well. So to check and or adjust the ignition timing without a strobe light, you simply remove the two plugs, the two caps, and the CDI cover. What used to be called the points cover, now it's called the pulse generator cover, if you want to be really fancy. I've removed the caps and the CDI cover, and we can see the pulse generator plate, the two screws. These are cap heads, so I can use Allen keys on my bike, but on your bike they will be JIS. So what we do, using a 19mm socket, turn the engine anti-clockwise until the timing marks line up. So I'm not sure if you can see, now the F for the fire or ignition is lined up with the pointer inside the case. And when that happens, if we look across to the ignition, this line on the pulse generator should line up with this line on the rotor. And it's not quite there. So what we can do, using the R Allen key, slacken off the two screws. Then with a flat-bladed screwdriver, we can put it in, we can rotate the cam plate until it lines up. So, how accurate is that? Let's use the strobe light and see how accurate it is. So we've connected one lead to the spark plug, the other to a battery. We'll start the engine, press the trigger, and let's see if we can capture this on video. So I don't know if you can see or not, but pull the trigger on the strobe light. and see if it will freeze the... I'm not sure if you can see that. The timing mark just to the right of the F is bang in line with the pointer inside the case. So the timing is absolutely spot on. So I tightened the two Allen screws, refitted the cover, and that's the job finished. If you enjoyed this, please consider subscribing, it's free. That way you won't miss out on any future content. See you in the next video.